I want to talk about the geometry of Lubin-Tate space and its relation with local Langlands correspondence in some special case. First, we recall the statement of Carroll conjecture. Roughly speaking, it says that local Langlands correspondence and local Langlands Jacquet correspondence are realized in cohomology of Lubin-Tate space. This was proved by Boyer and Haristera. Depending on global automorphic argument. So the geometry of Lubin-Tate space was not so studied, and the correspondence was not so explicit. So natural questions are, what is the relation with geometry? Of Lubin-Tate space. And how about the explicit description? Call some known result. Let K be non-Archimedean local field. Of the residual characteristic P. And K be maximal real. Of OK. So there are many researches on explicit description of these correspondences, but I think the most striking one is the study by Bushnell-Inyar. They gave a description of these correspondences for essentially tame representations. Essentially tame representations mean, on the Galois side, it means it is irreducible representation of the form of induction of character from tamely ramified extension. This is tame extension, and chi is a character of WL. This is a wide class of representation. For example, the dimension of Galois representation is prime to P. It is automatically essentially tame. As for geometric study, Yoshida constructed a semi-stable model of some Lubin-Tate space. He constructed of a Lubin-Tate space of full level pair. And in the reduction, in the semi-stable reduction, they he found deterministic varieties, and it realized local Langlands correspondence for the representation of the of this form. But here, L is unlamified extension, and K is tame character. After the work of Yoshida, Boyachenko and Weinstein constructed a family of affinoids. In the Lubin-Tate perfectoid space setting. Lubin-Tate perfectoid space is a Lubin-Tate space with infinite level structure, and it has a structure of perfectoid space in the sense of Schultz. They constructed a family of affinoid in this space, and constructed a formal model of affinoid and studied their reduction. So in some sense, their work is a partial construction of conjectural semi-stable model, but this part has already contained interesting representations. So in this case, they found an analog of deterministic varieties in the reduction, and it realized the local Langlands correspondence for representation of this form where L is unlamified over K, but K is arbitrary ramified characters. So our research in the same line as the work of Boyachenko Weinstein. So we will work on Lubin-Tate perfectoid space. Today I want to consider the case for n-dimensional representation of Swan conductor 1, which we call simple epipelagic. So in this case, as I said, if P does not divide N, the representation these are essentially them. Otherwise, they are not written as induction of character. So even if we allow totally widely ramified extension, we cannot write this representation as induction of some character. Such a representation are called primitive representations. Okay. Next, I recall a little about Lubin-Tate perfectoid space. let K be the residue field. Of our local field, and Q is the order of K. We take a uniformizer of K. Lubin-Tate perfectoid space, which we write MKN is the connected Lubin-Tate space with infinite level structure, which is a deformation space of the formal OK module. Of height n over residue field. This perfectoid space is a limit of usual Lubin-Tate space, but we consider the connected version. So this is a limit of geometrically connected Lubin-Tate space. And this has a formal model spoof A over OK up hat. This is maximal abelian completion of the maximal abelian extension of K. We can construct this ring A as the limit of ring for usual Lubin-Tate space with finite levels. We don't recall the definition of A, but the structure of A was studied by Einstein. We will recall the structure theorem of this ring A. There is a natural isomorphism between this ring and the following explicit ring. Divided by some explicit relation. Don't recall the definition of delta, but we can construct delta explicitly, and this is this is n because we divide by one relations. Yes, this coordinate can be defined as a limit of, on the finite level, we have some coordinate comes from modular interpretation. This coordinate comes from limit of usual coordinate. But the isomorphism depends on the choice of uniformizer. But this element, we can describe this element, which is element of we can describe this element also as a limit of something expressed. This is an element of OK abhat. This is a usual element. This is also a limit of a usual element constructed in the Lubin-Tate theory for height 1. And the variation of t is 1 over q minus 1 for normalized variation. Okay, now we can state the result. Let G be the product of three groups, GLNK and D cross. D is the division, central division algebra over K with height 1 over N. Times value group. And we define one part of G. This is a subgroup of G. G up, which consists of elements satisfying in this relation. Then this one, G1, act on the base change of Ci. Base change of Lubin-Tate perfectoid space to Ci, where Ci is the completion of the algebraic closure of K. We construct a family, a finite family, of affinoid. This is some finite set in Lubin-Tate perfectoid space in M K N. The map process precisely over C with formal models Zi satisfy the following condition. First of all, the special fiber of this model is the perfection of something expressed. It is smooth. A fine Artin-Schreier bright we take perfection with respect to Q's power Frobenius map. And we will explain more on these varieties later. And stabilizer HI inside G1 of these affinoids. Stabilizer of ZI. Naturally act on this formal model, especially on its reduction. At last, the compact induction from HI to G of middle degree cohomology of this ZI bar realize local Langlands correspondence and local Jacquet-Langlands correspondence for simple epipelagic representations, where L is different from P. So here, if we take home from this space to simple epipelagic representation of GLMK, then we will have a corresponding representation of Weyl group and division algebra up to some Tate-Twist normalizations. Next, I want to explain some construction of these affinoids. Let tau be n-dimensional simple epipelagic representation. First, we consider the case where P does not divide N, which we call tame case. Assume P does not divide N. In this case, tau can be written as induction of character. Where L is a tame extension of K. So we can write L as K phi with phi to N is equal to pi for some pi. So tau can be obtained as induction of chi. This is a character of WL. So this representation can be realized in the cohomology of zero-dimensional Lubin-Tate spaces. So in our context, zero-dimensional Lubin-Tate perfectoid space is just a point. So for this representation, the desired affinoid is also 1 point. We take the point. So this is a character of WL. So we work on Lubin-Tate space for formal OL module of height 1. This point, so this is just 1 point space, and this point correspond to formal OL module. OL module G over OC OC with infinite level structure. Which consists of five multiplication compatible system in the torsion point of G. So this is a formal OL module over C, but we can consider this as formal OK module. So here we take formal OK module G, and using this level structure, we can construct for level structure on G as height of H formal module. So we consider Pi n, where I is greater than zero, and then I n plus one. Then each system make a compatible system for pi multiplication, and these system give a level structure of G. So by this construction, we have a point of Lubin-Tate perfectoid space for formal OK module of height n. This is a CM point by the construction, which has CM by L. So by the representation theoretic reason, this tau should live near this CM point. The coordinate of Xi satisfy a simple relation. So this has n coordinates and which satisfy Xi I is equal to Xi I plus 1 to Q, because phi multiplication send some system to the next one, and by the construction of this isomorphism, phi multiplication will change to Q's power in this coordinate. So we have this relation. Now we can because the uniformizer also changed. So in the above setting, uniformizer of L is phi, but in the below, uniformizer of pi. So height will change. define an affinoid by the following relation, xi minus 1, the variation of this is greater than y equal to 2nq to I minus 1. For all i. Then we can. So then we after the definition, we will study this delta on this locus, and we will have some reduction of the formal model. So in this case, reduction is isomorphic to the perfection of Altenschlager variety defined by these equations. Ah, sorry, n minus. Order. So sorry, I don't understand. Yes, it depends. I think some different order can be. So we can change one point to another point by the action of the GLN and division algebra. But this coordinate is useful for our calculation. Next, I want to think about wild case. So it means P divides N. For simplicity, we assume that N is a power of P. And P is not 2 for simplicity. First, I want to imitate this construction without thinking about anything. So we will just imitate the construction. We will define L as by adding phi, which satisfies this relation. Then construct a point xi and define affinoid. Actually, we will have the same result. So we will have an affinoid, and the reduction is isomorphic to perfection of this variety. But if P divides N, this quadratic form degenerates. So the middle cohomology of this variety will vanish. I think the cohomology outside the middle degree will not vanish, and this variety, the cohomology of this variety will contribute to some non-supercuspidal representation in some way. But this is not we are searching today. So now I want to think a little more on representation side. apparently the problem is that tau is not the induction of character over L. And as I said, we cannot write the tau as induction of any character. But there is some restriction to some term extension of tau can be written as induction of character. Here, T is a term extension. More explicitly, this is an unified extension over this field of degree prime to P. So in this case, we have the following expectation. We want to study this tau. And by the restriction to T, this becomes an induction of character. So we have hope that this representation, the affinoid for this representation live near some Cn point which has multiplication by M. So Cn, there should be a Cn point by M in Lubin-Tate perfectoid space over for T and height N. So the expectation is that there is some point here and there is some operation here. So I want to construct some point, but I don't know how to characterize this point, and I don't know what this is. So in some sense, I don't know what I want to construct, but I will try something. First, we will study the character chi, which appears in the induction. Then this chi factor through some explicit extension, maximal randomified extension n. Where this n, we can construct this n. So this is an extension of m, and which is an extension of t. We have k here. And first, we can define some field f here. And this is a composition of f and t. The F is generated by one element over K, which is beta. Beta is defined by the following equation. So in some sense, the essence of chi comes from this extension n over t. And we can descend this extension to some extension over K. So I hope that some point should be related with this extension. So it would be nice if we have Cn point which has multiplication by f. But there is no such Cn point. No Cn point by f because the extension degree is bigger than n. So we never have such a Cn point. But I want to stick to this idea for a while. So we never have such a Cn point. But the Cn by f, I think this is equivalent to Cn by beta, because f is generated by beta over k. So one observation is the following. So our point should have some multiplication by beta, and a power of beta is very close to phi inverse, which was defined there. So, and the difference, so this, if some point has multiplication by beta, which also has multiplication by this element, and it's close to phi inverse, so I think this some point should be close to the Cn point we constructed there. And the difference is also important. We define gamma by the difference of these two elements. Beta q p2i is equal to phi inverse times something plus times 1 plus gamma. This have some high valuation. So if so the point should have multiplication by this element, and we decompose it as two product. This phi will become 1 over q power as above. And we cannot multiply this element using using modular interpretation. So instead of that, we just multiply this element on the coordinates. We need a little modification related with coordinate. So we will modify gamma to gamma prime. Gamma prime is defined similarly as gamma. By changing uniformizer to this element, these elements have the same variation, but we will multiply this element on the infinite coordinate, so we will modify gamma so that which fit in the infinite coordinate. We will change this pi to this element which have the same variation, then we can define gamma prime. We will use Gzai, which we constructed here, and Gzai, we define Gzai zero as power of Q's power of Gzai one, and define some point Gzai prime in MKN by the following condition. First, coordinate. So if we have no modification, we will have here xi 0 to 1 over q, but here we will multiply the modification. After that, we just modify, just multiply phi. So next one is defined by a power to 1 over q. And we will continue until n minus 1. At the last, if we define xi n prime by xi n minus prime to 1 over q, then this coordinate doesn't satisfy the equation for Lubin-Tate perfectoid space. So, but this point is very close to a point in the Lubin-Tate space, so we will change the last equation to almost equation. Then we will have some point in the Lubin-Tate perfectoid space. This point is characterized by these equation plus some congruence relation at the last coordinate. Then we can define an affinoid. Using this xi prime. Similarly, the definition is not exactly the same as the same case, but so it's a bit complicated, but it is similar to the same case. Then we will have an artificial variety in the reduction, which is isomorphic to the, which is defined by the equation of this form. This time, this part is does not degenerate, and M is greatest common divisor of E and F, and F is defined by the equation Q is equal to P to F. So we have some varieties, so the next step is to study their cohomologies. We will skip this step, but so if we want to study the cohomology of this variety, we can By using Kunes formula, it suffices to study the cohomology of this curve without this term and some variety defined by the equation without this term. And actually, primitive representation essentially comes from this Arithmetic curve, and this coordinate contributes as some character twist. But the character twist is important to make local Langlands correspondence, such as this had appeared also in the description of local Langlands correspondence for essentially tame representation, which was called rectifier. So this contributes as some analog of rectifier. So after we will study cohomology of this variety, we will have some explicit correspondence in the cohomology, but it is very non-trivial to check that the obtained explicit correspondence are actually local Langlands correspondence. So we will, I want to explain something about this. Here, assume that n is a power of b for simplicity. Then, also in this case, there is a research by Bushnell et al. They have a simple characterization of the correspondence for this case. So, assume that tau is simple epipelagic. The correspondence by local Langlands, so pi correspond to tau, then this correspondence is characterized by the following condition. First is on the condition on refined Swan conductor. Tau is equal to refined Swan conductor of pi. I don't recall the definition of Swan conductor, but these live inside k cross over uk 1. And if we take variation of these elements, we will have usual Swan conductor. The second one is the usual one, which says that determinant of tau is equal to central character by RT map. And the third one is the coincidence of epsilon factor. We will omit the additive character here, and the correspondence is characterized by these conditions. This is simple in the sense that we don't require epsilon factor for pair with other representations. So this characterization involves only representation tau and pi, only them. So this is a simple. So we actually, Bushnell et al. Studied the explicit description of tau according to this characterization, and they give a description of restriction to enriched subgroup of tau. So the description has already determined correspondence up to some unified character twist. So our essential task is to remove the unified twist ambiguity by checking this condition directly. So we will check this condition. Actually, condition one is easily checked, so I will skip this. The condition is a bit difficult, but so this tau can be realized as cohomology of this variety, and so as I said, this contributes as twist, so it is essential to study the cohomology of Arithmetic variety. So this cohomology of this Arithmetic curve decomposes into cohomology of Arithmetic shifts, so the direct summand will become that tau. So the problem is reduced to study here I should write determinant of Frobenius. Determinant of Frobenius on H1C summand Arithmetic shift. This is Q-spar Frobenius. it is essential to study the action of determinant of action of Frobenius, and it is related to this problem. This is some Martin Schreier shift. So this is equivalent to a global epsilon factor for the character of Galois group of function field for P1. So we can use product formula to calculate this determinant. So use Dorin-Normon. We use it only for rank one case, so it is due to Dorin, but anyway, we can use it. So an important remark is that if we check one and two, then it has already implied three up to P2 is root of unity. So this involves some unramified twist. But by the remark, it suffices to study epsilon factor after taking restriction to WT. Because, so in general, if we take a restriction to some finite extension of degree n, then the epsilon factor of the restriction has information on nth power of original epsilon factor. But in this case, extension degree is prime to p, and we have already know the equation up to p2 is per root of unity. So it suffices to study after taking restriction. So the problem becomes an epsilon factor of some explicit character. But it is still difficult to calculate this in this setting. We reduce the problem to the case where characteristic of K is P. This field is enough ramified over the base field K, so we can use the result of Dorin, which compares the epsilon factor of characteristic 0 and characteristic P. So we can reduce to this positive characteristic case. Then after that, we can reduce to the case where residual field is FP by considering this extension. So after this reduction, we can check the equality if P is not 2. But if P is 2, there is some still problem. In this case, we will reduce to the case where E is 1 by the following fact. So our character comes from this big Galois group. But after taking some unramified twist, it will factor through a small group z over 4z. This is a special phenomenon for p is 2. In general, for odd prime p, it factors z over pz. But in the case p is 2, it never factors through z over 2z. And this degree 4 extension is the extension which will appear as n over m in the case e equal 1. So everything comes from this case. So in some sense, the problem is reduced to GL2 case. Here, again, by the remark, in the GL2 case, we has already know the equation up to sine. So by the remark, it suffices. To show equality of non-zero real part by going to C. Actually, this equality of real part is a trivial equation. So the difficult calculation of Artin-Leshkovsky law involving this extension will affect only on imaginary part, but we don't need to see the difficult part. It becomes trivial one. That's all. T. I might make mistake. This is an unramified extension of yes, this I might make mistake here.